Hello, how are you? I hope you're good. Today I have another little exciting announcement, hopefully. This was definitely a team effort of me and you guys over on Twitter. We decided, do we want this to happen? How do we make it? Do we make it for 7 or 10 days? This is another and last for 2018 Magical Readathon bit. If you're not familiar with the Magical Readathon that I host, it's basically a Harry Potter inspired readathon from one Potterhead to another. I won't go into the detail of how it works, but I will instead link all of the videos down below that explain it. If you want to see what this is, if you like reading, or if you want to go back to reading, or you also like Harry Potter and you think it's motivating, I will link that all of that down below. But for those who are caught up, let's move on. So, the last 2018 readathon is indeed going to be a festive theme one because we are pushing it and it's going to be definitely December. I've decided because of the time of the year, we should go on and have a little fun that is not necessarily related to studying. So then I thought and thought and thought on how to make this fun and a bit more playful and interactive. Also, a little disclaimer, I know that not everyone celebrates Christmas and I am not personally big on any of the celebrations around this time. I went for Christmas because this is what they celebrate in the books and in the movies, so I hope that regardless of what you celebrate, you can join in and enjoy it as well. So first of all, I asked you guys if you wanted this to take place during the Christmas or before, and it was literally 49% voted during and 51% voted before, and since it's so close, I decided, let us compromise. So the main readathon bit is from the 17th of December to 23rd, which is a full week, but plus I added 3 days, so we cover that one as well. So we're not taking away from the main week, but technically it will last 10, so it's from the 17th of December to the 26th of December, both days included. So I'm gonna show you a little sneak peek. This is how our readathon sheet looks like. I really am hopeful that you guys will enjoy what I came up with. As you can see, this is a little bit of a maze. So we start up here and our goal is to attend the Christmas feast. This is the famous feast where you get to eat so much and sit with the people who stayed at Hogwarts for Christmas and all the teachers and have some really jolly time. So we definitely want to attend the Christmas feast, but we can pick up some activities on the way. So I've done this one a little bit differently. Basically, you will have to choose your own path of how you're gonna get to the feast. And each of the flags will have a different reading prompt. However, I would highly recommend you mainly choose based on the activities that you would actually want to do. You can only go the way that the little footsteps go. So you can really like cross over if the two flags don't connect. So for example, you can go from here to here. You know what I mean. So in total, there should be 6 prompts for everybody. However, there are specifically made so that you could really easily adapt it to be something really doable. For example, I am a relatively slow reader who is also sort of slumping at the moment. It might pass by the time, but I am. It's definitely made in a way that you could integrate a lot of short books or comics or graphic novels, and the 6th one right here is not even a book. So what I'm saying is that I hope that I made it customizable enough for you to suit your own pace. Okay, so let me just walk you step by step and then I'll go into a little bit of more details on what are the rules. The very first flag that we all start with is to finish your coursework. Now, this is something new that I've never tried before, so we'll see how it works, but basically it's just tie everything up from all of the studying that we've done this year. So this is actually a prompt to finish what you're currently reading. And this is again really depending on your ability. If you want to leave maybe the majority of the book that you're currently reading, or if you want to read it so you only have 10 pages left and have like a really strong head start for yourself, whatever makes you feel better. The reasoning of why I wanted to include this is that sometimes it is very hard to start a readathon and feel really unfulfilled when a lot of people around you are reading a lot of books and you feel you haven't finished one. And this, I feel, might give a lot of us this like really nice kick off, like no matter how we do for the rest of it, we already read something for it, you know? But equally, you can start reading a 500-page book and then have 200 left, you know? So it's like still a good chunk. This also sort of means that there's no like strict start date, because technically you can start this or just carry your current read into the readathon, because that's something I also sort of find annoying, because sometimes there are a couple of days before the readathon you want to do and you feel like, oh, I can't really start anything because I have to wait for the readathon, which is a normal thing, but I thought for the funsies in this one I'll include little point here at the very top to finish up what we're currently reading. What do you think about that? Do you like that idea? I don't know. Then you have your first choice to make. You can either go left and help Hagrid decorate the Christmas trees. You know how he usually brings like 12 of them to the Great Hall? There's a lot of work. And I feel like setting up a Christmas tree and decorating a Christmas tree with Hagrid with magic would be an experience, you know, it would be really fun. See, if you've decided to do that, you would need to find a book with golden details. Now, literally like 80% of the books that I have some sort of golden detail. Either it's on the title of the spine, it's like a little foiling on the cover, it doesn't have to be foiled, it can be just like a deep orange. I was trying to make these fairly easy, but obviously, you know, fairly adaptable as well, but I will also obviously write the prompts down in the description bar, and I will attach a couple of versions of this to suit everybody's needs. I have a white version, the parchment version, and also a gray version of this. Or you can go and have a snowball fight with Weasley twins, like they did in the fourth book. Obviously that is also a very fun option, depends on what you prefer. And for if you choose that prompt, you have to choose a book or a read that you think is gonna be really fun, very humorous, just giggle worthy, really. And then we will all meet up at Three Broomsticks to have some chill time and to drink some mulled pixie wine or a beverage of your choice, especially if you're underage, then probably something non-alcoholic. But I thought it would be nice to, after most of us go like separate ways, to come back to Three Broomsticks and all hang together before we go separate ways again. And this prompt asks you to pick a read that you think will only take you around an evening to read. So a quick one, you know, to get things moving again. Then we have three choices. The most left one is to exchange presents at your common room. So whichever common room you are, to just gather around and do this like secret Santa or secret Father Christmas, how they would call it in Hogwarts probably. Just to have a really cozy evening with your friends. And if you would choose this option, the read prompt is to read a book that you think, or to the best of your knowledge, the book includes a strong friendship or is about a friendship. Basically, a friendship is a thing in the book. I know sometimes these are kind of hard to judge, but as far as you know? You could also choose to sneak into the kitchens to bring some odd socks as Christmas gifts to Dobby. And for that, the prompt is to read a book that features an item of clothing on the cover. And yes, this does include any cover with a person on it, because usually, I mean, usually they would be wearing clothes, like some are not, but usually they would. So that might be not too hard if you have a lot of books with people on the cover. But it doesn't have to be on a person, could just be a separate thing, you know, shoes count too. And the most right one is to attend a Yule Ball. We are not gonna go into the nitty-gritty of like, why would there be a Yule Ball? Would it be on the actual day of Christmas? You know, we're just gonna not do that. This is all for fun, you know, nothing too hard about that. But I also really wanted to include a Yule Ball because I think it's such a Christmassy thing to do anyway. And because especially Hermione spent so much time preparing for the Yule Ball in the fourth book, I thought it would be appropriate to include a prompt for this specific category, that you have to pick a book that you feel like you've been either mentally or physically preparing to read for a while. Maybe it was the size that bothered you, maybe it's a second or third in a series that you sort of like, you were preparing yourself to grab it, maybe you kept pushing it for newer releases and you're constantly thinking like, oh, I just need to get back to that. This is your chance, this is your prompt. Maybe you wanted to attend a Yule Ball and at the same time get that sorted. So something you have been preparing yourself for. Now it really depends on what you chose before. So if you choose to exchange presents in your common room, you have two choices afterwards. You can either fly around snowy Hogwarts grounds, which would include reading a book that has some sort of buildings on the cover of the book, comic or whatever you read, or you can open your yearly present from Molly Weasley and put on your knitted sweater with your initial on it. For this one, the prompt is to read a book where the family is a strong theme, or where the parents are present. So if it's a YA contemporary, one that will have the actual parents present, because you know, when a lot of fantasy, the parents are not present. But there are some that, you know, they have that. Now, the Molly sweater is also a choice if you decide to go to sneak into the kitchen to visit Dobby. So you can choose that too. Again, refer to the graph, it will be clearer there. Or you can use invisibility cloak to get into the restriction section of the library. A lot of people went home for Christmas and a lot of people are busy with other jolly activities, and it's a very perfect time to just do some mischievous things and go and get some reading done of the reading that you otherwise would not be allowed to. I think it's a naughty reader stuff to do, so quite a few of us might choose this, especially maybe some Slytherins, I don't know. And the prompt for this, I think, is very appropriate, and it is to read a banned book. Now, it can be banned in not necessarily in your country, but banned somewhere else. If you Google a list of banned books, a lot of things will pop up. So that's one way to find it, and maybe you'll be surprised that some are in your on your shelves. And fun fact, Harry Potter is banned in quite a few places, so if you can't find anything else, that one can do as well. If you chose to attend a Yule Ball, you can also use the invisibility cloak to get into the restriction section. Or you can go and visit the owlery and see Hedwig and give her a festive treat. For that one, it's fairly simple, is to either have an animal on the cover or in the title of any sorts, you know, or series name even. So anywhere, animal in anywhere. And those are all of the choices, and no matter where you are at the bottom here, the only way to go now is to attend the Christmas feast. And the last thing to do when you attend the Christmas feast is to watch a Harry Potter movie. Now, this is more of a reward than anything else. Obviously, if you're not a massive fan of Harry Potter, you don't have to do this. You've done all of this reading and now you can relax and watch some Harry Potter. And if it happens to be on Christmas Day or Eve, then that's even better, but it doesn't have to be. It could be on the Boxing Day, because that's the last day of the readathon. But yeah, that is the goal. The goal is to get that movie watched, and or just reaching that little flag here if you don't want to watch the movie. So technically there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 categories that you need to choose something from. As I said, you can only go from one place to another if they are connected by the little footsteps. There's no real reason why I did this in some sort of Marauders map style, but I just thought it would be fitting because, you know, Harry Potter. But I just sort of wanted to do it in a way that is more playful, especially because this is sort of goofy stuff and we do have Weasleys quite a lot here, and, you know, the map did come from them. To Harry at least. But yeah, what do you think? Do you think this is clear enough? I hope it is. As always, in the Magical Readathon, there is no crossover. Professor McGonagall is very strict on that, so if your book fits quite a few categories, unfortunately, it will only have to satisfy one of the prompts, so we cannot cross over to the other ones. Now, any form of a book, ebook, physical book, audiobook, counts as a book. Anything that counts on Goodreads counts as a book. Again, so that includes graphic novels and comics and some short stories. If it's on Goodreads and you can put it as to read and read, it counts. Now, I know quite a lot of us like to read more than one book at a time, and obviously in this type of setup you can only go forward once you read the previous one. For those who do read more than one at a time, it's not a problem. Just you can read a couple at a time for different prompts and different places of the map that you will definitely go for. The only thing is that, for example, if you fulfill, like, put your Molly's sweater on, but then by the time the readathon ends you still haven't read anything for exchange of presents in your common room, then you did not reach the Christmas feast. Do you know what I mean? So you have to, everything has to be able to connect by the time the readathon ends, and basically you win the readathon by attending the Christmas feast. If this is something that's really out of your reach, because we're all very, very different, and so, like, I will definitely incorporate a lot of comics and mangas and whatnot in here, because as I said, I cannot read 5 books. Maybe I could on, like, very good week, but, you know, I don't know how busy I will be and all of us will be, because it's festive season, you know. Don't stress about it, it's all just for fun, but this is the setup, so I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions at all, I will try my best to answer you as soon as I see it. The chances are other people will answer you instead of me as well, because there's a lot of magical people here that are super, super helpful as well. Now, there's probably gonna be some sprints and some fun questions and quizzes or some polls or something over on our Twitter. That's the sort of like the main platform, and it's at Magical Readathon. I will link it down below as well. So if you have Twitter, make sure you're there for the Magical family meetings as well. There's also a Discord channel for those who prefer that, with some common rooms, so you can sort yourself in a common room and then you'll be taken to your common room that other people from other common rooms cannot sneak a peek into there, so it's all very exclusive. But there's also the Great Hall and the Astronomy Tower and Quidditch Pitch. Like, there's a lot of places for different topics. It's basically like a fun forum, so I will link that down below for you as well. I think that covers everything, I hope. I will link everything that you should need down below. So I really, really hope you're gonna join us. The next thing after this is probably gonna be just the owls. I don't know if there's gonna be anything else after that. Zeus is on my shelves. Excuse me, down. That's gonna wreck it. Anyway, guys, I'm gonna go. Let me know if you're gonna join us. I really, really hope you do. Stay awesome, stay kind, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Zeus, down.